sense enjoyment. This sense enjoyment has driven us crazy. We have become crazy. We have become madman. Though we know everything, still I think, no. So we have to become gentlemen in spite of becoming madmen. How we can become gentlemen? We can only become gentlemen by accepting this process of devotional service, vidhi bhakti, which is described in the Bhagavatam. Sabe pumso paro dharmo yato bhaktir adhokshade ahaituki apratihata yayatma suprasidati. It's mentioned in the Bhagavatam. This is the duty of all the living entities, all the jivas. We are all jivas. To perform a devotional service to the Supreme Lord, adhokshaya. Adhokshaya means who is beyond our sense perception. Our blunt materialistic eyes cannot perceive the Supreme Lord. We can't perceive Lord with these blunt materialistic senses. Even when Lord wanted to show the universal form to Arjuna, he said, Dibya Chakshu Dadami Ham. I will give you the transcendental eyes. By those eyes you will be able to see my this universal form. So we cannot perceive Lord with the blunt materialistic eyes. It's not possible. We need to purify our eyes. You know, Brahmaji also couldn't perceive, couldn't understand Krishna 5,000 years back when Lord Krishna was displaying his beautiful pastime here on this earth in Vrindavan. So Brahmaji saw him, but pastime was going on. Krishna was taking food with his cowherd boyfriends. They're enjoying. When Krishna was young, he used to tend calves. When he grew big, then he start tending the cows. Now, what happening? Some Krishna's friend, their food, they put Krishna's mouth, Krishna put in their mouth. And Brahmaji is watching, how this boy can be a god? He stole all Krishna's boyfriends, cowherd boyfriends, and all the calves to test Krishna. But Krishna, who is the all personality, supreme personality of Godhead, he expanded himself in all those boys and the calves' farms. For 1 year this Leela was going on. After 1 year, Brahmaji came and saw, same. He was thinking, I stole all of them from where they came. He went where he has put them into sleep. Came there, they are there. Then Brahmaji appeared before Krishna. Then there were tears in his 8 eyes. And he, to please Krishna, he recited some shlokas, they call Brahma Samhita. He said, Premanjana Shurita Bhakti Vilochanena Santa Sadeva Hiradeshu Vilokayanti Yamasham Sundra Achinta Guna Sarupam Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Vajami. He said, my Lord, one cannot see you, one cannot perceive you with the blunt materialistic eyes. To see you, one has to put the ointment of love. Premanjana Shurita Bhakti, one has to become your devotee. He should be blessed by Mother Bhakti. Premanjana Shurita Bhakti Vilochanena Santa Sadeva Hiradeshu Vilokayanti. Saintly person always you keep you in their heart. You know, they see you in their heart. Krishna's original form is a dark, dark form. Yam Shyam Sundra, he is white also. In the estimation of the gopis, Krishna has become very fair complexion. Ras Bihari. But our Govindev in Jaipur, you go, they are the original deities of Srila Rupa Goswami. They are black, dark. Yam Shama Sundar Chinta Gunasarupam Govinda Madhi Purusham Tamaham. Point is to see Krishna, we have to put the ointment of love. This is the message. And we have to become devotee. This is the purpose of life. If someone says, I am very fallen, I am in Maya, this and that, then hell is waiting. Doesn't matter who, may be me, you, he, she. But because of ignorance, because child is in childish, because a boy is in a childish nature, can't understand studying, we can't understand, we don't understand, then my business is to become a devotee of Krishna. Come to the shelter of Krishna. So here, it is mentioned by Srila Prabhupada in the purport. Samadhi means fixed mind. The basic dictionary, the Nirukti, says, Samyag adhiyate asmin atma tatva yathadmayam. When the mind is fixed for understanding the self, it is said to be in Samadhi. If I examine my mind is running here and there. No. Mind is very, very fickle. Huh? Mind is very fickle. Similarly, our mind, you know, if we examine our mind, is running here and there because of why mind has become so fickle? Because of too much sense enjoyment, which is mentioned here by the Lord. In the minds of those who are too attached to sense enjoyment and material opulence, and who are bewildered by such things. They are bewildered by such things. The resolute determination for devotional service to the Supreme Lord does not take place. They can't become a firm devotee. No, I have to become a devotee. So in this country where you are living, sense enjoyment is very prevalent, and our Bharat, India is known as a tapo bhumi, and this is known as a bhog bhumi. In India, people perform austerity. They live very austere life. But here, people, everybody wants to enjoy. Everybody is after sin, but they are not happy. They want to enjoy. There's one saying in Hindi, Tune socha tha bhog main bhog karun, par bhog hi tujhko bhog gaye. Jine apna banaya tha tune, shamshan mein chhod kar laut gaye. Sab kuch in par kurban kiya, aur man ki pyaas bhuja na saka. Duniya bhi to teri ban na saki, Bhagawan ko apna bana na saka. You thought of sense enjoyment, but you couldn't enjoy the senses. Now senses are enjoying you. There is happening in Bombay. There was one very rich man. He invited one saint, Gujarati saint. This person was also, rich man was also Gujarati. He invited one saint. He served them the prasadam in golden and silver utensils. He was a very rich man. Now saint is asking this rich man, you also sit and eat with us. He said, no, I will eat later, I will eat later. He said, what is the difficulty? Just sit with us and eat. No. Saint kept on insisting upon the please sit and eat. Then, you know, what happened? Truth came out. He said, this rich man said, actually, I can't eat all these things. I said, what do you eat? He said, I only eat buttermilk and a rotla, made of, you know, this one, different, you know, roti, chapati type. I can't eat anything. He was suffering so much. That was his food. Before he rich man, he must be trying to enjoy his senses. Now the senses are enjoying him. So, sense enjoyment is condemned. One who is interested, actually everybody should be interested to go to back home, back to garden. We were enjoying the senses in animal kingdom also. A dog, a cat, a lion, they don't enjoy their senses. This is easily available to them without any restriction. But human form means, human life means a human being must follow certain rules and regulations. If a human being is not following certain rules and regulations, then he cannot claim to be a human being. It's two-legged animal. So, what is mentioned here by Srila Prabhupada, that when the mind is fixed for understanding the self, it is said to be in samadhi. Samadhi is never possible for persons interested in material sense enjoyment. Samadhi is not possible for those persons. Those who are interested in material sense enjoyment, it's not possible for them. What further Prabhupada is saying? In material sense enjoyment and bewildered by such temporary things, everything here is of temporary nature. Last words of Prabhupada, very important. They are more or less condemned by the process of material energy. They are condemned by the process of material energy. Devotees, we should try to become a devotee of Krishna. Brothers and mothers, devotion means service, service means a devotion to Sri Krishna. And Lord Chaitanya has described this. What Lord Chaitanya has described? Na dhanam na janam na sundarim kavitamba jagadisha kame mam janmani janmani ishware bhavatad bhaktir ahaituki tvai. O Almighty Lord, I have no desire to accumulate wealth. Nor do I desire beautiful woman. Nor do I want any number of followers. What I want, only your causeless devotional service, birth after birth. This is a pure devotion. Only pure devotion will purify our existence. Devotional service to the Supreme Lord should be unmotivated, no motivation, and uninterrupted. Then only purification will take place. Devotees, in the short, purification is needed. We are all pure, but due to our contact with Krishna's inferior energy, we have become impure. Now our only business should be that how I can purify my existence. Shuddhena, shuddhena satta. How I can purify my existence? And if I am not able to do this, generally people are not interested, then they are very unfortunate. They are gliding down towards hellish condition. While departing from this material world, nobody is going to help them. They will be forced to leave this world alone and put into suffering condition. Srila Prabhupada used to say that if you won't follow rules and regulation, you won't become like a human being, then suffer, what can be done? If a boy doesn't study, doesn't go to school, in future, he won't be able to understand that time, but later on, he has to suffer. Unqualified boy, what is going to do? He's going to work in the field, a labor, to fill his belly. Educated boy will, you know, get a good job, example. Similarly, if we won't become Krishna conscious, we won't elevate ourselves from the material platform to the spiritual platform, then suffering is waiting for us. Suffering is very, very actually suffering, so much suffering, of which we have no idea. No idea. In the Garuda Purana, Garuda Purana is cited by Lord Vishnu. The carrier of Lord Vishnu is Garudji Maharaj. Vishnu, Krishna, they are same. He asked this question to the Lord, my dear Lord, those who are your devotee, they go to your abode, they stay with you, enjoy your association eternally, serve you eternally. But those who are not devotees, those who are sense gratifiers, those who are sinful people, what happens to them? This is the question of Garudji Maharaj to Lord Vishnu. So what is the reply of Lord Vishnu? It's in the Garuda Purana. Lord Vishnu is saying, my dear Garuda, you asked this question. But what happens to the non-devotees, sinful people, those who after sense enjoyment, one who commits sinful activities, the one who is after sense enjoyment. One who is a devotee will never commit sinful activities because his needs are very limited. Simple living and high thinking. So, Lord Vishnu is saying, my dear Garuda, you asked me this question, what happened to the non-devotees, what happened to the sinful people? After hearing this, you will be horrified. Simple by hearing. Like there is one hell. There are 29 different kinds of hell are described in the Garuda Purana. Hells are described in the Bhagavat Mahapurana, so in the 5th canto. It is mentioned, there is one hell. One who lies, he is put in a certain hell. One who is a sex monger, he is put in a certain hell. One who is, he has a power, he is misusing that power. He is put in, whole description is there. So one hell is there. The floor of that hell is made of copper. Which kind of copper? Red hot copper. Copper becomes hot very quick. And that soul is put there. Actually, there is one body called Yatana Deh. Yatana body is given. And that body, if you cut into pieces, he will suffer, but he won't die. That is called Yatana Deh. And he has to suffer. He is put there, he can't sit there. It's burning. Keep on dancing for millions of years and suffer. Soul suffer like anything in the Yatana Deh. So these things are there. We are all very fortunate that Srila Prabhupada has appeared to lead us back home, back to Godhead. So we should avail this opportunity. Our mind is running here and there, committing so many sinful activities. We should try to understand. We should try to control our uncontrolled mind and become devotee. Actually, Lord Chaitanya is very, very merciful. Vaishnavas have described him, patita pavana heto tab avatar, mosam patita prabhu na pai guvar. Rotam Das Thakur is saying another song. In this song, Lochanda Thakur is also saying the same thing. Bhakti Vinod Thakur is also saying the same thing. Amara jivana sada papirat, nahi ko punya ralesh, pare raudbega diya chi ekat, diya chi jive rakalesh. Is all the means bad things. He's saying, this is my life, Thakur Bhakti. No, no. This is life. This is my life. But pure devotee is also taking him as an ordinary person. So, please try to understand. Take to this Krishna consciousness seriously. By the mercy of Srila Prabhupada and all the predecessor acharyas, especially chanting, nothing to play around, Prabhupada used to say. Don't play around, Become serious. Prabhupada came in the dream of one of our God brothers in Vrindavan. His name is Bhakti Siddhanta. He is in Vrindavan for many years. Prabhupada told him to stay there, and he is there. And Prabhupada was mentioning him, you stay here and make the murtis. He's making. And Prabhupada came in his dream and told him, be serious, be serious. So, we have to become serious, not to play around, you know. It's not good. Then we will be simply sorry when time is past. When time is past, then nothing can be done. So, please repeat after me, louder. Hare Krishna!
Hare Krishna!
Hare Krishna!
Hare Krishna!
Krishna Krishna!
Krishna Krishna!
Hare Hare!
Hare Hare!
Hare Ram!
Hare Ram!
Hare Ram!
Hare Ram!
Ram Ram!
Ram Ram!
Hare Hare!
Hare Hare!
Spreading Krishna conscious holy name all over the world. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki
Jai!
Shri Shri Gaur Nitay ki
Jai!
Shri Shri Pancha Tattva ki
Jai!
Shri 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 Nath Bhagavan ki
Jai!
Shri Shri Sitaram Lakshman Hanuman ki
Jai!
Shri Shri Jagannath Baldev Subhadra Mata ki
Jai!
Shri Shri Radha Govinda Bhagavan ki
Jai!
Nitay Gaur Premanandi Hari Hari Nitai Gaur Premanandi Hari. All glories to Sambhala Bodhis. All glories to Sambhala Bodhis. All glories to Sambhala Bodhis. All glories to Shri Guru and Gauranga. All glories to Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna. Any question anybody has?
We have no chance to shravan shastra adhyayan. Shastra adhyayan, shastra gyan. We have to shravan by shravan.
Hearing, hearing.
There is no any sentient person in this country.